Dirk down low. He'll shoot over Grant. Same spot on the floor that he scored 30,000 points is where he makes it 31,000 points.
Ah, that's beautiful.
I've been stacking money high on the low, working on my flow, separate my friends from my foes.
What's up with the YouTube? It's Gohar TV, and we're back with another video. And in this video, we're going to talk about Dirk Nowitzki and the effect he has had on the game of basketball. But before we jump into that, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe. You know what I'm saying? We got like 13 subscribers. We're on the road to 100 subscribers, so every subscription helps. So subscribe, comment, like the video if you like the video. If you don't like it, dislike it, whatever that is. But let's jump into the video. Dirk grew up in the small town of Würzburg, Germany, where he shared the house with seven other people: his mom, his dad, his older sister, his aunt, his uncle, and his two cousins. And growing up, Dirk played tennis and handball. His dad was a handball player, and his mom and his older sister played basketball. But it was Dirk's older cousin that introduced him to the game of basketball. And once Dirk played basketball, he fell in love with the team sport. He told his dad he was done with handball and tennis. It was when Dirk was 16 that he met his mentor, Holger Gesswinder. Holger saw a potential in Dirk that Dirk didn't even see in Dirk. Holger believed that Dirk could be the best player in the NBA, but Dirk didn't think it was possible. Holger told him, if you want to be the best player in the NBA, we're going to have to train every day. When he was 18, he scored 50 points on NBA Hall of Famers like Charles Barkley and Scottie Pippen. And even Charles Barkley saw the greatness in Dirk at a young age.
When I played against him over 16, he was like 18 years old, and he scored like 50 on us. I tried to give him money to go to Auburn.
Yeah, exactly.
I told him I knew he was going to be great.
It's a man of high principles.
I'm telling
Dirk,
man. That would have been a great investment.
It was in the 1998 Nike Hoop Summit event where the Dallas Mavericks head coach Don Nelson saw Dirk play for the first time. Dirk had a great game against the American players, and this is when the coach decided that he wanted to take Dirk in the 1998 NBA draft. Dirk was selected 9th overall by the Milwaukee Bucks in the 1998 NBA draft, but was soon traded to Dallas in a 3-team draft day trade. The start to Dirk's NBA career was not all peaches and cream. He struggled to adjust to the physicality and the speed of NBA players. He averaged only 8 points and 3 rebounds per game while shooting 20% from 3-point line and 40% from the field. By his third season, he was Dallas's leading scorer, averaging 21.8 points per game, 9 rebounds, while shooting 38% from 3-point line and 47% from the field. He led Dallas to their first playoff appearance in 11 years. He then led Dallas to 12 consecutive playoff appearances, along with 2 finals appearances in 2006 and 2011. Now let's talk about the 2006 finals a little bit. Dallas had a chance to send the game into overtime. Now this was a Miami Heat team with Dwayne Wade, Shaquille O'Neal, Gary Payton, Udonis Haslem, and Alonzo Mourning. And this young Dwayne Wade averaged 35 points per game in the finals. But when he missed 2 clutch free throws to seal the deal and turn the game into a 2-possession game with 10 seconds left, Dallas had a chance to tie the game and send it into overtime. Udonis Haslem got the offensive rebound from the 2 missed free throws, but then he was called for a travel. This left 9 seconds on the clock, and Dallas down by 3. Now guys, if you're Dirk Nowitzki, you have to take this last shot. I don't care, you're the best player on the team, known for shooting 3s, you have to take the last shot. But Miami did a great job of denying him the ball, and Jason Terry just missed the open 3. He wasn't clutch. And Miami went on to win the finals 4-2, beating Dallas in game 6 in Dallas. Now let's fast forward to the 2011 finals, where Dirk was a man on a mission. He was the only superstar on his team. Miami had Chris Bosh, Dwayne Wade, and LeBron James. They had a straight super team, the Big 3. That's what they called them, the Big 3. They had a super team with the Big 3. Dirk just had a great role players on his team, but he was a man on a mission and would not be stopped at any cost. He was killing Chris Bosh in this series. Fadeaways, 3-pointers, taking him to the goal, dunking on him. He just didn't have an answer for Dirk. Miami didn't have an answer for Dirk. They went on to win the finals. And Dirk solidified his greatness with this playoff performance, winning finals MVP and winning the championship. Guys, Dirk is one of the most loyal players to ever play in the NBA. He is one of 2 players to spend 20 years with one franchise. The other is Kobe Bryant with the Los Angeles Lakers. Dirk has never played the game of basketball based on money. In fact, he's never had any endorsements outside of one shoe deal with Nike. He has never had an agent or business manager. He negotiates all his contracts with the Dallas Mavericks himself. Dirk once said, "Once you start looking at the game of basketball as a job, you might as well stop playing because there's no more fun in it." He said that he does not play the game of basketball for the money. So it's not about the money with this guy. And you can tell he plays strictly on the love of the game. He has been known to take pay cuts in order for his team to go out and get the best players in the free agency. In fact, he took one of the biggest pay cuts in NBA history, leaving $72 million on the table. With that being said, Dirk has made nearly $245 million, so he's pretty well off money.
I'd say I was the first one, but definitely I came in at the right time where the league was changing. You know, I think when I first got in the league, it was a lot of one-on-ones, a lot of post-ups. The fours were all big and posting up, and they changed the rule. They put in the zone. Everything opened up more. That was perfect for me.
Well, Dirk Nowitzki really has changed the game in so many ways.
He was. With his style of play, he really changed the game. Let's be honest. He's the reason there's a pure stretch five in NBA 2K. Dirk created this position. Before he came into the NBA, there wasn't any post fours and post fives, stepping out, shooting threes, stretching the defense. Nowadays, you got guys like Kevin Love stepping out, shooting threes, Kristaps Porzingis, Brook Lopez, Anthony Davis, DeMarcus Cousins, just to name a few. Before Dirk came into the league, almost all of the bigs were back to the basket post-up type of bigs. Nowadays, it's rare that you find bigs that play with their back to the basket. Maybe a Dwight Howard, but how many of those type of bigs are there in the NBA? The majority of the bigs now have range and can shoot threes and can also take you off the dribble. And this can be accredited to Dirk. One of the most notable players in the NBA that emulated his game after Dirk is Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant is like Dirk 2.0. He can shoot the three, he can drive, he can post up, and he also stole Dirk's 1 foot fadeaway. He's even on record saying that he wanted to try and be like Dirk. He said, "One of my friends was like, the Diggler got 28 in the first half. I was like, shit, that is a lot of points. I watched it back. One-leggers, pull-up jump shots, threes, pump fake, one dribble pull-ups, all the fundamentals. I was like, that's who I want to try and be like. Durant is a 7-footer just like Dirk. But all the things that Dirk does, Durant does too, just more athletic." Now, Dirk is one of the greatest players to ever play in the NBA. He's 6th on the all-time scoring list, and just recently he scored 31,000 career points. He's an NBA champion, NBA Finals MVP, NBA Most Valuable Player, 13-time NBA All-Star, 4-time All-NBA First Team, 5-time All-NBA Second Team, 3-time All-NBA Third Team. He's part of the 50-40-90 Club. 50% field goal, 40% three-point, 90% free throw. And he won the NBA three-point shootout in 2006. So Dirk definitely has the accolades and resume to validate him as the greatest European player to ever play in the NBA. And for some, he might be the greatest power forward to ever play in the NBA. But he's definitely top three. But I want to see how you guys feel about Dirk. Where do you guys rank him? Leave a comment below. Let's get a conversation going. Hey, it's been a pleasure hanging with y'all. But until next time, you know what it is. Go hard or go home.
God damn, I am that nigga. I am the man. I stand and deliver. I am never a quitter. Might fall off, but a nigga always get up. God damn, I am that nigga. I am the man. I stand and deliver.